dismissed Philippine town mayor Alice Go allegedly evades arrest after reportedly fleeing the country back in July. But as Victoria Tulad tells us, Go's lawyer insists the disgraced former official is still in the Philippines.
Based on this document obtained by Senator Risa Ontiveros, dismissed Bamban Tarlac Mayor Alice Go has already left the Philippines and arrived in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia on July 18. This despite the Bureau of Immigration statement that it has not yet monitored her leaving the country.
Hindi po pwedeng ipagkaila na siya ito dahil match na match po ito sa kanyang Philippine passport na ipa-flash ko ngayon. Maraming salamat sa NBI sa impormasyong ito.
From Malaysia, Go allegedly had another destination.
Ayon sa aking isa pang source, Mr. President, tumuloy si Alice Guo sa Singapore, kung saan nagtagpo-tagpo sila ng kanyang magulang na sina Lin Wenyi at Guo Jianzhong. The couple flew in from China on July 28, 2024. Mistulang reunion sila doon kasama sina Wesley Guo at Cassandra Ong.
According to Ontiveros, Go was able to evade cameras in the airport since she supposedly passed through blind spots. The question now is, who helped Go leave?
Who allowed this travesty to happen? Sinong may kagagawa nito? Hindi makakaalis si Alice Guo kung walang tumulong sa kanya na mga opisyales ng pamahalaan para tayong ginisa sa sarili nating mantika.
Go Huaping is the alleged real name of Go, who is believed to be a Chinese national. Meanwhile, according to government sources of ABS-CBN, Mayor Alice Go left Manila on July 18, 2024 via Batik Air and landed on the same day in Kuala Lumpur. Then on July 21, Go boarded the Jetstar Asia Airways Flight 686 and landed in Singapore. She stayed in Singapore until early morning of August 18, 2024 and then took a ferry going to Riau, Indonesia. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian says Go is insulting the government because just last week, she even filed a motion to reopen the Department of Justice's preliminary investigation on her human trafficking case.
Talaga pong pinaglalaruan ho tayo at iniinsulto ang ating institusyon. Sa counter affidavit, meron pong notary public na notarized na sa San Jose del Monte, Bulacan. At pinapunta ko ho yung staff ko to verify. Nakausap po ng staff ho natin sa telepono at ang sabi ho ni attorney, si Guo Huaping ay pumunta sa kanya personally on August 14, 2024.
The Senate will invite Notary Public Attorney Elmer Galicia to their next hearing. Go's legal counsel, Attorney Stephen David, meanwhile admits he doesn't know the Notary Public who signed Go's counter affidavit.
Hindi ko kilala yung lawyer na yun kasi Notary Public yan. Kung ako kasi abogado ako, alam mo namang controversial yung case na yan ni Mayor Alice. Halangan namang magpirma ka ng isang dokumento, papatunayan mo nasa Pilipinas siya. Kung wala siya, kasi pwede ka
madisbar.
Pwede ka madisiplina na Supreme Court. Kaya itataya mo ba yung pinag-aralan mo na ilang taon dahil lang sa isang firma na yan? Wala akong alam na abogado na gagawa ng ganyang hindi totoo. So ako, naniniwala ako.
David says Go assured him that she is still in the Philippines, but he did not discount the possibility of Go seeking political asylum in another country.
Tinawagan ko siya. Sabi ko, naghinahanap ka na naman dito. Nakalabas ka naman ng Pilipinas. Sabi niya, hindi. Kasi sabi ko, gusto ko, malaman ko na dito ka sa Pilipinas. So hindi, para yung legal strategy ko, maayos ko. Kung wala ka na sa Pilipinas, kung yan talaga yung decision mo, meron naman na tayong options dyan. Sabi ko sa kanya, sabi mo lang sa akin kung nakalabas ka na. Kung nakalabas ka, de, punta tayo sa bansa na may political asylum at doon tayo magagawa ng mga dokumento para makalaban tayo.
The DOJ meanwhile says if Go has indeed left, a thorough investigation is needed to hold those responsible accountable. The Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission, for its part, is still awaiting official information from its foreign counterparts. According to the Office of the Solicitor General, the cases it filed against Go won't be affected even if she has left the country. Victoria Tulad, ABS-CBN News.
Two ships of the Philippine Coast Guard damaged following Monday's collisions with Chinese vessels. BRP Bagakay and BRP Cape Engano were on a resupply mission to troops in Patag and Lawak Islands when they encountered the Chinese Coast Guard. The Chinese side then conducted dangerous maneuvers. The PCG believes China may have thought the Philippine vessels were going to the Escada Shoal.
So many days ago, the Chinese have always been complaining on the presence of BRP Teresa Magbanua in Escada Shoal. We can just the main reason why the Chinese government thought that the two 44-meter vessels, 4410 and 4411, are proceeding to Escada Shoal to reinforce the 9701 is probably what they were thinking. Yeah.
The latest incident also drew condemnation from the U.S., but for retired Supreme Court Associate Justice Antonio Carpio, this cannot be used to activate Manila's mutual defense treaty with Washington.
This is not an armed attack, so we have to talk to our U.S. allies to redefine what is the meaning of armed attack, how do we classify gray zone tactics. This is a gray zone tactic. We have to redefine just to deter China not to do this.
Political harassment. That's how the Duterte family described accusations linking them to a massive drug trade last 2018. Man Scarpio, the husband of Vice President Sara Duterte, insists former Customs Officer Jimmy Guban is lying, citing his history of fabricating affidavits. The Duterte couple asserts the allegations are baseless and politically motivated.
Lahat ito ay political harassment, political attack.
The leaders of the House Quadcom firmly denied this. They vowed to find the truth, shrugging off criticisms by the Duterte and their allies.
Yung investigation naman namin started last year pa eh. Hindi pa naman sila naghihiwalay ni BBM during that time. So I think wala naman political harassment.
Yeah, walang political attack dyan. Eh, siya ang vice president. Ako, congressman lang ako. Bakit ko siya atakihin? Ako rin nagulat ako nung binanggit ni Jimmy Guban ang kasama yung asawa niya. So, yes, I'll have to explain.
The Philippine Health Department records the country's first mpox case this year. The new case is a 33-year-old Filipino male with no travel history outside the country. Health authorities are tracing who the patient came in contact with. Last week, the World Health Organization declared mpox a global health emergency, the second time in 2 years after a deadlier strain of the virus spread in parts of Africa.
May close and intimate contact siya before the symptoms started. And the symptoms started more than a week ago, started with fever. Itong mga symptoms ng mpox, ano? At 4 days later, nakita yung distinct rash sa kanyang face, back, buttock, trunk, sa dibdib at abdomen, sa groin, sa palms and soles of the feet.
Meanwhile, Congo hopes to receive its first doses of an mpox vaccine by next week. Congolese health authorities say Japan and the U.S. have pledged to donate mpox vaccines to the country as it deals with a deadly outbreak of the disease. Mpox vaccines are widely available in Europe and the U.S., but African countries have no access to the shots. Global vaccine group Gavi, meanwhile, said it will spend up to $500 million to bring the much-needed vaccines to African countries. Let's get an update on the weather now from Pagasa forecaster Veronica Torres. Hi, Veronica.
Hi, Katrina, and all of our audience in ANC. So currently, we're monitoring a low-pressure area inside the Philippine Area of Responsibility. It entered the PAR last night at 8 p.m. And at 3 a.m. today, its center is at 1,030 kilometers east-northeast of extreme northern Luzon. So this low-pressure area has a low chance of developing into a tropical cyclone in the next 24 to 48 hours. Meanwhile, southwest monsoon is still affecting extreme northern Luzon. For the weather condition of Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers and thunderstorms. So we don't have any gale warning raised over any parts of the country. And that's the latest from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Thanks for that update, Pagasa forecaster Veronica Torres. Rewards continue to pour in for Filipino medalists in the Paris Olympics. The Philippine Senate confers medals of excellence to dual gold medal gymnast Carlos Yulo and to bronze medalist boxers Ira Villegas and Nestle Petesho. Yulo was given 3 million pesos in cash incentives. Villegas and Petesho received 1 million pesos each. Yulo was also given a separate Heroes Welcome Monday in his hometown of Manila. He was given 2 million pesos and a city council resolution declaring August 4 as Carlos Yulo Day in the city. The Manila local government says this will not be a holiday but a commemoration of Yulo's first gold medal victory in the Paris Games.
So, gusto ko lang po magpasalamat at nakakilala po ba, hindi lang bilang atleta, yung mga coaches, mga Olympians po, na-recognize po kami ng government. Nagpapasalamat ako sa mga support ang binibigay at pagdadasal ninyong lahat sa amin.